We're asking, please save the questions for the question and answer portion of the meeting. If you want to ask them in person, just hold on to them. If you're worried that you may not remember a question you may have, feel free to type it in the chat. And then when we get to the end of the presentation, we will we'll answer those questions that are in the chat. We'll go back to that and answer those questions.
Oh, there we go. Are you in? I'm in.
All right, folks, we are asking, as I said, everyone to please mute your microphones during this presentation so that we can have a smooth presentation. We don't get any feedback or anything like that with multiple devices in a single family. So we are gonna take two on this. I apologize for the initial hiccup of not having our large group license tied to this meeting. The agenda for tonight, if you wanna go back to slide two, we'll have an introduction of our staff administration. We'll have some welcome videos, a virtual tour, an introduction to the freshman house. We'll take a look at our career and tech center, and then our athletics and some of the different programs offering our, we skipped a slide.
I'm sorry, the feature isn't working very well for me, so I apologize for that.
So we'll have our athletics, our student clubs and organization. We'll look at our student advocate office, just a student generated welcome video. And then again, we'll end the evening with our questions and answers. So we'll head next to our school administration. All right, so. Again, my name is Kevin Carpenter. I am the principal here at Kent High School. Our vice principal is Katie Meserve. Our director of school counseling is Jen Murphy. Virginia Schrader is the MWV Career and Technical Center director. Neil Weaver is our athletics director. Nikki Tuning is our student advocate and Eagle Academy director. And Susan Tafani is our special education coordinator. All right, so first off, we've got a couple of videos. We'd like to start with a little meet the administration, and then we'll have a quick virtual tour. Again, anyone, please mute your microphones.
Hello, my name is Kevin Carpenter. I'm the principal here at Kent High School. My role, I oversee all aspects of how Kent High School is running, from the day-to-day items, as well as the long-term plan for our success in the future. My job is to make sure that our students and our staff have the resources and the opportunities to have a great educational experience that is both rigorous and most importantly, relevant. As we look to the 2021-2022 school year and welcome the class of 2025, I'm really excited to try and return to normal as much as possible, but also to look to bring with us all the new things that we've learned from the past year. We're excited to welcome you to Kent High School, where there are tremendous opportunities waiting for you here. Welcome and have a great end to your eighth grade year, and we'll see you all here soon up at the Nest.
Hi, my name is Katie Meserve, and I'm the vice principal here at Kennett High School. I work primarily with the freshmen, and you will be able to find my office on the second floor where most of your core area classes will be. I'm very excited to welcome you to Kennett High School for your freshman year. Things that I'm excited about for next year are a return to normalcy and some more social aspects of school getting put back in place. Things like sporting events and field days and spirit weeks, pep rallies, all the fun stuff that we haven't been able to do this year, you guys will hopefully get to enjoy next year when you join us. So excited to meet you all.
Hello, my name is Virginia Schrader. I am the director of the Mount Washington Valley Career and Tech Center here at Kennett High School. We are very excited to have you join us in 2021. And can't wait for you to experience all the exciting programs we have in the Career Tech Center.
Hi, welcome to class of 2025. My name is Jennifer Murphy. I am the director of school counseling. So I actually will work with you around scheduling and college and career readiness, as well as all three other in the department. I look forward to 2021 when you guys come into the building that we can remove this layer of stress that has been added in regards to the pandemic, and that we can get the energy back in the hallways and in the cafeteria and out on the fields and in the gym, and having building more team spirit and school spirit. Look forward to you guys coming.
Hello, everyone. I'm Susie Tafani, the Special Education Coordinator at Kennett High School. I'm looking forward to welcoming all of our new and returning Kennett Eagles, bringing back so many of the things that make school and learning fun for each and every student. We have overcome so much adversity as a community over the last year, and I'm proud to continue this journey and grow together.
Hello, my name is Nikki Tuning. I'm the Student Advocate and Eagle Academy Director. Welcome to Kennett High School. I am looking forward to the return of the fun and social aspect of the high school experience.
I'm Neil Weaver, the Kennett High School Athletics Director. Welcome class of 2025. I look forward to seeing you on the fields, courts, slopes, and track. Let's go Eagles.
Hello, my name is Kevin Carpenter, and I'm the principal here at Kent High
School. Did this.
My role, I oversee.
What?
Oh. Can I just ask whoever is speaking to please mute your microphone?
I'm
back to the like elevator. So like elevators all over everywhere.
So we did have a few people join us as we were going through that. I would just ask anyone who's new here to please mute yourself as we continue the presentation. So the next item that we have is talking about our freshman house and some of the enduring understandings that go along with this. The freshman house is composed of three different teams, and I'm just apologize reloading because there was a video that goes with that. Skip ahead right to that slide. So the goal of the freshman house, as I said, is the importance and need for tolerance and respectful interaction with all members of the community and how to appropriately use the resources available to them to manage academic and social challenges, the preparation, time management, self-advocacy, and developing effective inquiry skills will lead to improved academic success. And that active learning occurs through collaborating, taking risks, and overcoming setbacks. And really to help facilitate that, our freshman team have core groups of freshmen that they work with. They share team members. So that the teachers can collaborate with these incoming students and really create a safe place for these incoming eighth grade students to transition into. So we will show the video now, just introducing you to our freshman teams.
Hi, I'm Miss Sargent, your science teacher this year.
I'm Coach Dude, math teacher.
Hello, I'm Jeannie Woodward, Miss Woodward, and I am your world cultures teacher.
Hi, I'm Miss Reynolds Albert, and I am a special educator on the team.
Hi, I'm Miss Jones, I'm your school counselor. Can't wait to meet you.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Murphy, and welcome to our team, and we are excited to see you all come to high school next year.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Tilden, I teach freshman English. I'm also the current English department head.
Hi, I'm Nicole Nappy. I'm a special educator, and I'm here to support anyone on the team.
Hello, my name is Mr. Taylor, and I teach science.
Hi, everybody. I'm Mr. Frankel, and I teach math, both Algebra 1 and Geometry.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ms. Verdeau. I teach world cultures, and I am the team leader on this team. I'm also an assistant track coach here at the high school. And we want to welcome you, and we are so excited to have you join us here at the high school and learn how we all work together and how you can all work together as a team as well.
Hi, I'm Mr. Lachlan, the special educator on the team.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Herlihy, math teacher on the team.
Hi, Nate Jales, school counselor on the team.
I'm Mr. Mahan, English teacher. Hello.
I'm Ms. Littlefield, science teacher.
And I am Mrs. Sear, your world cultures teacher. Welcome, class of 2025. We can't
wait to meet you.
This time I'd like to turn it over to our career and tech director, Virginia Schrader.
Virginia, you're muted. Classic Hi. Line of 2020.
Sorry about that.
As you can see, the screen is loading with all the programs that we offer at the Career Tech Center. We have 12 inspiring programs to get you thinking about your future. And we are very excited to have you join us next year and hope that you take us up on trying at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these classes. We have intro classes in every single one of these programs, so you can try it out and see if you would like to join us in the Career Tech Center. So thank you so much for being here tonight, and we'll see you next year.
Good evening. My name is Jennifer Murphy. I am the Director of School Counseling at Kennett High School, and I'm going to talk to you about the program of studies, our schedule, how to pick courses so that you are all set for next school year here at the high school. First, everybody was given a hard copy of the program of studies and a course selection sheet last week. The hope was, since then, you've been having conversations with your parents, your teachers, your school counselor, to determine which courses and which level of courses are going to be the best fit for you. So there is also a copy of the program of studies on our website here. So I just want to bring that to your attention in case you need it. Also in the program of studies, I wanted to talk about what our schedule looks like. So our schedule has 4 blocks in it and then a flex advisory. The year is broken into 2 semesters, and then within each semester is a quarter or 2 quarters. So for example, this student in quarter 1 was taking a PE class, block 4, and second quarter was taking an intro to machine tool class. So the rest of these courses are semester in length. They gain a full credit while quarter classes gain a half a credit. While talking about credits, at high school, you need to accrue a certain amount of credits, that being 25, to be able to graduate. And those credits need to be in these particular areas. So for example, you need to have 4 credits of English by the time that you graduate, so 1 a year. So in core classes, when we use that terminology, we're talking about English, math, science, and social studies. And for elective classes, we're talking about everything else. So that's PE, health, career tech, art, music, and world language. Although we do consider world language a core class, but it does get categorized as an elective credit. So we keep track of your grades and your credits on what we call a transcript. And this is a document that will follow you for the rest of your life. So it's really important on the first day of school that you start working hard to accrue these credits and keep good grades. So now that you have had the time to figure out what courses you're going to take and your course selection sheet is all filled out, you will log into PowerSchool to actually put your classes in. Now, Tamworth and Robert Frost students, you also have an added step where you need to create an account in PowerSchool. So on the back of the course selection sheet, there are directions on how to actually set up your account. So once your account is set up, then you will sign in. And you will click this class registration button, and it will bring you to a screen that looks just like this. So please notice on the right-hand side, there are green marks and red marks. Now, when you log in, your red marks are gonna, there are gonna be more of them. I've tried to do some of this so we can get through it a little quicker. So any red mark where there is needs to be resolved. So for here, the student has not selected a math class yet. So to pick your courses, you will click on this pencil here, and it'll bring you to the courses that you are eligible to take. So this student is going to be taking Freshman Algebra 1A and 1B. So I'm going to click OK. And once that's done, you'll notice that that has red mark has turned into a green check. So you're going to be making sure that all of these subjects here have green checks. And once you have that green check all across the board, you can actually go and submit your courses. You'll be taken to this screen where you have the opportunity to review what it is that you selected. So if you have any questions, please reach out to your school counselor at the middle school first. And if they are unsure, you can certainly always reach out to us at the high school. So we look forward to having you join us and become part of our Eagle's Nest. And we hope that this process is easy and you enjoy tonight's event. Good evening. My name is Jennifer Murphy.
All right. Next, I'd like to bring your attention to our Office of Student Advocacy. So our student advocate, as we mentioned earlier in the evening, was Nikki Chuning. In her office, working out of her office, we have Michaela Thomas. She is a student assistance program counselor. This program helps students who may have any issues around possible substance misuse or anything like that. And she runs small groups and does some education services and outreach with our health classes and other programs. She's there to lend a hand to students and just a friendly face around the building. And the administrative assistant is Lindsay Brandon. So things that are provided through that office: community resources, substance abuse support, snacks for students that may need some extra pick me up to get them through the day. And it's just a safe place to come if any students have any sort of issues inside of school, outside of school. And if we don't have the resources right there in the office, we find connections for those resources in our community. Athletics, and you will hear more about this. We run an eighth grade meeting in June for our incoming freshmen specifically. But Neil Weaver is our athletic director. He was the gentleman doing all the pull-ups there. Colby Locke is our athletic trainer, and he's an intricate part of our team. We're very fortunate to have an athletic trainer. He is at all of our athletic events and then around during practice time. So if students have any injuries, he's good to help diagnose those. He's also fantastic working with our athletes for conditioning to make sure that they're in good shape and know what they need to do to prevent the injuries. He'll also be the person that you'll see as you guys come in for your initial impact test. That's our testing that we do for all our athletes to establish baselines for around concussions. So all incoming eighth graders will get an impact test. And then you'll just wanna make sure that you check on your most recent physical. If you're planning to participate in sports, you need to have a current physical from your physician. So make sure you get that well child visit with your primary care physician and have them sign off on that physical for you to participate in our athletics. The sports that we have, our fall sports include cross country, field hockey, football, golf, mountain bike, soccer, both men's and women's, and volleyball for women. Our winter sports include basketball, ice hockey, indoor track, and skiing. And skiing includes alpine, ski jumping, and Nordic. Our spring sports include baseball, lacrosse, outdoor track, softball, and tennis. And just to clarify, lacrosse is both boys and girls. So getting involved at KHS, another great thing at Kent High School is we have tons of different clubs and organizations. You know, some people, athletics is their cup of tea, but we have so much more to offer than just our athletic curriculum. We have great clubs and organizations. So we want to share with you a little video made and put together by some of our current clubs that we have at the high school.
We might need to refresh, Kevin.
All right, I will refresh that. Mm-hmm. There we go. Maybe not.
Thank you. teachers. I'm Mr. Mack, the gaming club advisor. In gaming club, we match wits and we sow chaos in all manner of tabletop games. So if you want to grab a board game and play with some friends, compete in Magic the Gathering games, or experience role-playing, come join us next year.
Hi, I'm Taylor.
Hi, I'm Ivy.
Hi, I'm Rambo.
We're the student leaders of the Fellowship of Christian Athletes Club that started new this year.
We aim to strengthen your leadership skills and characteristics
through your walk with Christ.
Just wait. This is the program for you. My name is Brian McGaffigan.
And I'm Joseph Hebert. We are cadets at Task Force Eagle, a program dedicated to prepare students for a career in military, fire rescue, law enforcement, and more.
As cadets, we learn civic responsibility, service, and commitment.
We learn life skills like leadership, mat reading, public speaking, first aid, and many more.
We also learn about career opportunities and
good
speaking.
We self-improve, advancing our skills and preparing us for a successful career.
Each session, we perform physical exercise to build strength and endurance.
Let your guidance counselors know you're interested. See you in September. Don't miss out. There are limited seats.
Hello, young engineers. I'm Mr. Mack, one of the advisors for the Robotics Club. In robotics, we design, tests, program, and compete using robots in various competitions throughout the year. We meet many times throughout the week, and we work in collaborative groups to win. So if you like mechanics, robotics, programming, or just really think robots are neat and want to see what it's all about, come join us next year.
Key Club is a student-led service organization for high school students. We work to create a positive impact in our school and community through our core values of leadership, character building, caring, and inclusiveness. We dedicate ourselves to volunteering and fundraising for various charities such as Kiwanis Pediatric Trauma Institute, Camp Sunshine, and UNICEF.
Ever wanted to be amazing at chess? Well, now here's your chance. We do practices and tournaments. Chess, not dramatic, but still fun.
I wonder what this could be. Hello?
Hello. Are you LGBTQ+ or an ally looking to join a club? Well, if so, you should really consider joining the SCA.
Okay, I'm coming out.
Don't be alone. Feel at home.
Kennett High School Outing Club is a club dedicated to outdoor adventures. It's a great place to connect with others who share a passion for the outdoors. The KHS Outing Club is a place where anyone can summit mountains, canoe through rivers, and take advantage of all of the natural resources that our valley has to offer.
So far this year, we've hiked up Peaked Mountain, Boulder Loop, and Arethusa Falls. The club also works to provide information about how to safely enjoy the outdoors. We would love to have you be a part of our adventurous team.
Hi, I'm Sam.
And I'm Grace. We're co-presidents of the SkillsUSA drafting team.
These projects that you're seeing right now, we have designed them in a program called Autodesk Inventor or Revit. We've been able to 3D print these objects by using a 3D printer.
As you continue with your 3D design skills in architectural and technical drafting, you can join our SkillsUSA team to further prepare yourself for any future careers in CAD, engineering, or architecture.
Hi, my name's Katie, and I'm a junior.
I'm Remy, and I'm a sophomore.
And we're part of Educators Rising, which is the CTSO for the teacher education program here at Kennett.
We're an organization that helps make sure teachers have the experience and skills they need to be ready for the classroom by providing hands-on teaching experiences.
We participate in events like Teacher Fest, Teacher Palooza, and we also have a state competition.
We hope to see you guys next year.
Bye.
Bonjour. Bonjour. I'm Nicole.
And I'm Grace.
And we are the co-presidents of French Honor Society. In French Honor Society, we have fundraisers for nonprofits and encourage high academic standing within our members.
To join, you have to meet a few criteria. The student has to be in at least French 2 advanced or higher and maintain an A in their French classes and cannot have lower than a B in any other class.
In normal years, we host a bilingual dinner with Spanish Honor Society. This is a ton of fun because you get to eat and make different foods with friends and family. I can't speak with the camera that close to my face.
If you have the opportunity, join French Honor Society.
Hello, freshmen. We want you to join
NHS, and this is what NHS is about. Character, leadership, service, and scholarship. So make sure that you work hard in school so that when you are a junior, you can be inducted into NHS. We hope to see you here.
We are the life of an athlete leadership team. Our goal is to help and support each other, our teammates, our school, and our community. As LOA members, we have pledged to live a healthy as well as drug and alcohol-free lifestyle. We hope that you recognize us as familiar faces in the hallways next year and encourage you to say hello. We welcome you to Kennett High School.
Hey guys, I'm Ella. I'm the student body president.
Hey, I'm Ava. I'm the student body vice president.
Hey, I'm Nicole, and I'm the senior class representative.
And we're from Student Council, and we organize dances, spirit weeks, and we change policies in the school that helps everyone.
So as you can see, we have a ton of different organizations that students can participate in and be a part of that go, you know, along supporting their education while they're here at Kent High School. So definitely very excited to show these to all our incoming eighth graders. And we highly encourage you to take the opportunity to check out these different organizations and see if any of them are a good fit for you. So that does bring us to the question and answer portion of the night. I am going to stop sharing my screen here. So thank you guys so much for everyone for being here. Again, if you've typed some questions in, we will have people read the questions. If you have some individual questions that you'd like us to to answer and want to ask them in person, please feel free to unmute yourself and ask those questions for us. But thank you guys so much for everyone who's been here with us this evening. Do we have anything in the chat yet, Ms. Murphy?
We do not.
Okay. And we do know, asking some questions in public may be a little nerve-wracking, so please feel free to type them in. If we don't remember our PowerSchool logins, do we message our guidance counselor or someone else?
Ms. Murphy, do you want to? Yeah, I was just going to say I'm unclear who has that information at the middle schools, but I'm sure any guidance counselor can certainly direct you to the right place if it's not them. Looks like Miss Bailey from Bartlett typed in and said it's your team leader. Thank you. There is a question about what the process is for signing up for clubs.
Okay, clubs have open enrollment. So a lot of them, as we start the school year, they'll put out some information about how you can join them and participate in their clubs. So come early September, as we kick off the new school year, there'll be opportunities for signing up for clubs. And usually we'll try and have some clubs do some stuff in the hallway. We're hoping to have a transition day for you guys. We'll look and see what the conditions are. But we'd like to have an opportunity for you guys at a minimum to at least get a tour of the building. But ideally, we'll be able to get you guys in for more of a formal orientation over the summer. So that will be our goal. Again, that will be dependent upon all the local conditions at the time.
There's a question about the presentation and how we started late. Thankfully, I didn't start recording until we added in the or change the setting to add in more people. But we do have it recorded and we will be posting that on the website probably tomorrow.
And we'll also post the presentation individually too. So if you only want to see parts of it, you don't have to watch the whole Zoom video.
There's a question about when registration opens. The portal will open in PowerSchool on Monday, the 15th, and that's when you'll be able to actually go in and pick your classes. There's a question about, will there be foreign travel opportunities?
At this point right now, we're still waiting for guidelines. We're not really doing travel outside New England, let alone outside of the country. There have been opportunities in the past. And again, those type of things, we don't have answers to that as of right now. But as things change, we'll constantly be looking at that and evaluating that.
Answered that question. The deadline for registration is the 19th. So you wanna make sure that you've entered in all of your classes in PowerSchool by the 19th. It's not just the worksheet. You've got to put them into PowerSchool. So there are lots of people to help. You can use the video that was made for reference as well. Next, we have a question about how to sign up for fall sports.
Fall sports, you'll have an opportunity. We're going to do a specific eighth grade meeting that will be in June. Our athletic director, Neil Weaver, will reach out to all the sending schools to make sure all eighth graders get information on that meeting. At this point, I would assume it will probably be a Zoom, although if again, conditions change and we are able to do an in-person, we could potentially do an in-person meeting and have that outside. But that will be forthcoming and it'll be in June. And if you don't sign up at that point, it doesn't mean you can't participate. There will be opportunities to sign up for any of our athletic programs over the summer as well.
The next question is, how do you get assigned a team? I can take that one. It's random, although we do try and make sure that there are students from Jackson on every team and students from Bartlett on every team. So the last thing we want to do is isolate any student. It's a random, mostly random, although we do try and make sure that the teams are evenly, have even male-female ratio and from different towns. We've got a question. Please share more about the freshman house. How much interaction do they have with the other grades? Is there a freshman house in one particular part of campus? Now we have a couple of freshman teachers on. I don't know if one of you want to pipe in and answer that question.
I can do it. So I'm Kat Murdo. Yeah, I'm Kat Murdo. I teach on the freshman house. So yes, it is in one particular part of the campus. Our classrooms for the core classes, which are the freshman house classes, are on the second floor. And they're pretty much each team is kind of next to each other. And then science is a bit down the hallway, but they're all really close together. In terms of interaction with the other grades in elective classes, there's some interaction with the other grades depending on the course. And then within the house, you know, depending on how things go next year with the whole COVID situation. In a typical year, we do try to get together and interact as a house. So across the teams, we'll try and do some interaction as well when we can have lots of people in one place.
And I can add to that, again, this is Virginia Schrader, the career tech director. When the freshman students, they will be in, when they sign up for intro classes, they could be in classes with sophomores as well. Sometimes even juniors take intro classes. So when they're in their career tech classes is when they really have the opportunity to interact with other students and other grades in the school.
And the same as was with PE, art, and some of those classes, they tend to be a mix as well. So great question.
Thank you. Next question is, how does lunch fit into schedules?
So lunch is going to be an interesting question. We'll look and see where we're at. So this current year, what we've done is we have three lunches, and students are actually eating lunch in whatever classroom they're in. That is a safety measure we've taken. Typically we have four lunches and each of those lunches is split across one of our blocks based off what subject area they're taking, and kids would eat in the cafeteria for 25 minutes. So we'll see what the conditions bring for next year. If we can open it back up and have students in the cafeteria, or if we need to continue to do lunches in the classroom. So we don't have a concrete answer for that, but it is tied into the one of your blocks.
Great. Next question is, when will we know team placement? I can take this one on. We will be drafting the first round of schedules before the end of the school year. So you will be sent a schedule, a draft schedule, and at that time, it'll be apparent which team you're on. So I would estimate around June, you'll know that information. And the next question, maybe for you, Kevin, will you be going back to black and white days or sticking to the schedule that was put in place for this year?
Yeah, so for the upcoming school year, we will not be going back to a black and white mode. This decision was made not knowing what we would be for conditions, and we wanted to have some stability for our teachers for planning for courses. And as we kind of come out of this, we are examining our entire schedule format and processing going forward beyond next year. So that will be an ongoing topic that our staff and our faculty are looking at and examining what's going to be the best fit for our students going forward. You know, one thing we've seen from this pandemic is we need to really look at all aspects of education. What are the practices that we have that are great? What are the things that maybe we need to move on from? And how do we make the overall experience better for all of our kids? So we are going to be in the process of revisiting that and looking at what will be the best possible schedule format for our students. So I hope that answers the question.
The next question is, are we going to be in the same number team we are this year, or will it change? It will change. They don't have any relation to each other. The next question is, do you get an assigned, we call them school counselors at the high school. And yes, you will. Each, we have myself as the director, and then we have three school counselors, Ms. Furtado, Ms. Jones, and Mr. Jouse, and each one of them is tied to a team. So based on what team you are assigned to, that will determine who your school counselor is.
and that school counselor will stick with you for your 4 years, so you have a consistent experience.
Exactly. Thank you for that. Now, next question. If we do a sport that is not in the school, will we be able to have that sport count as a half credit towards PE? Great question.
So in order for that to happen, we would need to go through the ELO process to do that and demonstrate which competencies that sport meets. If it is one of the school accredited programs, and if you participate in two different ones, then you can do a PE waiver, but we do have some recognition of a few programs in place. So yes, you can earn credit for those.
Great. How hard is it to switch classes if they are too hard or too easy?
Well, that one has an interesting one. Again, if we're in COVID times, last year, we were not really able to switch classes very frequently. We did look at every case on a case-by-case basis. In normal conditions, you know, there's an add drop period once the courses have started, and we're hoping we'll be back to that next year, a lot closer to those normal conditions, that we'll be able to have an add drop period where it's not a good fit, or a student doesn't like it or it's too hard, that they'll be able to make an adjustment to their schedule. So we do try and make that available for students.
And next question, will there be chorus, and is there a teacher assigned for chorus?
Our goal is to definitely have chorus and band back to normal next year. I know it's been pretty awful for those students that really, you know, enjoy music and the musical arts to not be able to do those to the fullest extent this year. Our goal is to get whatever we can back to normal. So especially chorus, band, and those classes that have had some pretty severe limitations on them.
And then a follow-up question is also, are music and chorus the same sort of thing?
No, we have two different instructors. We have a chorus teacher. She also does some of our dance. And then we have instrumental. She does our band, our jazz band, our ensemble, drumline. So Dr. Davison is that instructor. So we have two different teachers and very different, but both excellent programs with lots of opportunities for kids. We take the arts very seriously and offering them to our students. They're great opportunities.
Was there anything about theater?
We have had a theater program. I don't believe it's a class, but we do have a drama club where they typically do at least one, if not two productions per year. So we do have theater in the school, and we're hoping to again have that back and be able to have shows and get kids back into to the arts to the fullest extent we possibly can. Again, as I said, the arts are so important to a well-rounded education.
Is it possible to do drumline and football?
Yes, we've had people do that in the past. Some of the stuff with the drumlines, they do some performances, but there are performances outside of athletic events that they do. And if you reach out to the instructor, you absolutely can do that. I know she tries to schedule some practices outside of sports practice times as well. So she really goes above and beyond, making sure kids who have a passion for music have opportunities to play them, especially if they do have some other extracurriculars that they're involved with. And drumline is a class as well, so you can take it as a course for credit. It's not just a club. The club is in addition to the class.
And then tied to drumline, is there a requirement for past experience with band instruments?
I actually do not know the specific answer to that, but I'm sure if you have a passion for it and want to explore it, our music teacher would more than welcome you and have a conversation, try and bring you into the fold.
Correct. There's a question about our hood and hat policy.
We do allow students to wear hats in the school building. There are some specific instances where teachers may have rules within their own classrooms, but in the hallways, students are able to wear hats. so we don't deny that. But again, please be respectful that teachers may have a specific rule within their classroom, and that is the rule that needs to be followed.
All right. So is the dance team men and women?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And can somebody do dance team and a fall sport?
Again, you'd have to look at the schedule. I believe people have been able to do that, but that you'd want to sit down and talk to the individual instructor about that around the dance team. And some of the dance is tied to a class, so you may need to be involved with the class as well at some point.
We've gotten a few questions about our cell phone policy.
So the cell phone policy is similar to the hat policy. So students in the hallways between classes at lunch are absolutely allowed to use their phones and devices. However, if you're in a classroom, the rule of the teacher is what supersedes everything. So if the teacher does not allow the phones during class time, that is the rule, and that it will be the expectation. Each teacher has a expectation that they'll set for you around that. So you just need to make sure you know what the classroom expectation is for the cell phone. But when kids are out of the classroom and, like I said, in the hallways, transition, lunch, they do have the opportunity to use the phone. I do want to forewarn people that our service is not good up at the high school. There are many myths out there that we actually have a cell phone jammer. That is not true. I can tell you that, but reception is not great up at the high school. So there is a hard time sometimes getting service there.
And while we're on policy, how about dress code?
We do have a school approved dress code. That will be in the student handbook. You'll all get the student handbook. We're really hoping, like I said, if we can get you guys in for that orientation, we'll get that handbook out in your hands, but it has the dress code. I don't have the specifics to it in front of me right now, but we do ask that everything's kind of covered up and that's it's school appropriate, not wearing shirts that represent drugs or alcohol. So those are kind of the major components of the dress code. But if you have any specific questions, that is referenced in our student handbook, which all of you will get on the first day or before if we are able to do the orientation, like I said.
It's also on our website now. It may be adjusted somewhat, but if you want a deeper dive into it, you could certainly look at that on our website. We've got a question about, can freshmen sign up for college prep classes? And that is a big yes. You just want to be in consultation with your teacher to make sure, your current teacher, to make sure that that is the recommendation. Students can also sign up for advanced level classes, but those are conversations that you want to be having with your teachers and your parents to pick what is going to be best for you. We have a question from KMS principal, Mr. Bechet. When signing up for band chorus classes, will students be added for both semesters, or do they need to do something to indicate that?
So they can sign up for band, and then based upon their schedule, what fits into the schedule is where they'll be added to it. We're still working on how in the long term we're going to have a schedule that accommodates our music program, switching from the AB to the semester-based model. But sign up for it, and then, like I said, what the computer will put you where it fits within your schedule based on your other course selections.
There's a question about uniforms and having to wear them. This student was asking about chorus and band, so I'm not sure, Evie, if that is what you're asking about for uniforms. So maybe you can clarify that in the chat. We'll come back to that. And a couple of questions about do you need to have any experience with instruments and drumline? You do not. We've got a question about what types of dance does the dance team do?
They do a mix of dances. Ms. Fajere is our dance teacher, and she's been trained in multiple different types of dance. So a lot of it is built by the kids, and she helps choreograph, working collaboratively with the students. So they'll do all kinds, jazz, modern, I believe some hip hop. So all sorts of different styles of dance. And I did see a clarification question about the uniforms for band. Band, oftentimes, if you're talking about the marching band, they do have specific uniforms they wear. Drumline, typically, they'll wear a uniform as well for their stuff, just to look professional. It's one of those things where they really look pretty amazing when they're together as a group out there, and they all have the uniform, and they're in rhythm and in harmony, and it's quite the impressive group. If you haven't seen them live, you'll be excited when you do see them. They're awesome.
We've got a question about, can you start doing stuff to get your license? I don't know if you want to.
So driver's ed, we do partner with right now the Winnipesaukee Driving School. They have some specific requirements in terms of age that you have to be at the either the start of the course or by the end of the course. I don't have all the specifics on that, but they do offer classes year round. So they'll have fall, winter, summer, spring courses, and you'll want to try and connect with them in advance. I believe there's another driving school that's out of OSPE as well that some of our students use, but Winnipesaukee is the one that does actually, when we have driver's ed classes in person, come to the high school. And you can get picked up at the high school for your driving time. Right now, their classes are online, and I don't know if that's going to change back or if they're going to continue with that format going forward. The drive time is all in person, though. So in terms of stuff to do to be prepared, once you're 15 and a half, you can start driving with your parents by law.
All right, how can I get a reference from VLAX for a class at KHS? I'm not sure what you mean by reference, but when you sign up for a VLAX class, you can enter in a school counselor's name at the high school. If you are going to be taking a high school level class, you can put my name in, that's fine. And just make sure you're signing up for a high school class if you're looking to get high school credit. We've got a question about electives. The electives, if you go to the program of studies and look at the graduation requirements, it lists out the needed electives for graduation. So there's a full credit of band, a full credit of PE, a half a credit of health, a career tech class, and several others. So you just want to make sure you become familiar with that program of studies graduation requirement list. Catching up on the questions, can you eat in class? Can you retake classes even if you fail?
Eating in class, again, that'll be one of those teacher-specific rules. When we get to like the shops, in a lot of cases, those are absolutely not science labs. A lot of cases, you're not able to eat. But if it's a regular class, that's going to depend on the teacher. It also depends on the students and their ability to not make a mess of the classroom. So if students are responsible and teachers are willing to, then they can oftentimes eat in the classroom. But again, that's a case-by-case basis per class. So check with your teacher on the specific expectations for their classroom.
All right, I am just wanting to pay attention to time. Kevin, I don't know how many more questions you want to go through. There are a few more.
Yeah, we can try and answer some. Again, if you don't want to stick around with us, feel free to hop off if you don't have any questions. This is being recorded. We will try and answer a few more questions, but again, we are at about 10 past seven, so we are cognizant of everyone's time. But we'll answer a few more questions here.
Let's see, how many electives at a time? Can we change them if we get bored? So some of that goes back to, you know, COVID, not COVID. In pre-COVID, yes, you could change classes. There are certain time frames in that, which also can be found at the beginning of the program of studies. And depending on how many core classes you take depends on how many electives you can take. So we would recommend taking two core classes in a semester. Depending on how things fall, it may need to be three. And then you would have that fourth block for an elective, or two blocks for an elective. So it kind of depends on the courses that you request to take. Let's see. How many kids will be in class? It's kind of another COVID question. We're working within the guidelines that are set right now. So right now we have a maximum set at, for most classes, for 18. For the career tech classes, it's 16. We're gonna be creating the schedule in that manner unless something changes. And then we've got a couple of questions about lunch, and is the food good, and what is the selection?
Yeah, so Fresh Picks is the vendor that we use to provide our cafe services. They do have a varied selection. Again, this year's a little different in terms of what they're able to do because they have to package all the meals and send them out. So it looks a little bit different this year, but when people are in the cafeteria, they're able to go through, they're served, and they get the meals, and they have a little bit bigger variety this year. Like I said, they're working with us to package all the meals so that we can send them out to the classrooms, but they do a good job trying to have a variety of different things.
And maybe the last question about if you're currently a VLAC student or getting your education in a different way, you're homeschooled, how are you going to get teacher signatures that are required on the course selection sheet? We understand that this is a difficult time and that you may not have access to getting a signature. That is okay. We would suggest that you do email your VLAX teacher and ask for recommendations on what level, just because we want to make sure that you get placed in an appropriate level class where you will be successful.
You can also reach out to our counselors too, and they can take a look at what you're taking for classes and try and make suggestions based off the levels of classes, if you share transcripts or anything like that, depending on what you have for VLAX courses or what your homeschool program is. We're happy to help. All right. Can we go to the counselors? Counselors, usually we need to get you an appointment. You can check in and anytime if there's ever a crisis, absolutely we'll make sure a student is seen, but we do try and keep schedules so that counselors are not, people aren't just constantly walking into the offices. We want to make sure that they're available for the students. Anything more on that, Ms. Murphy? Ms. Murphy?
Nope, it's perfect.
Okay. Do I see a question about limited number of college courses? Is that the question?
Yeah, is there a limited number that they can take? There is not.
If you can fit them into your schedule, you can take them. There are different, as you get up there in age and grade, different options, dual enrollment, running start, early college. So we have a whole bunch of different opportunities for college credit that you can earn at the high school level as you get out of your freshman year and into your sophomore, junior, senior year. Particularly our Career Tech Center has a lot of agreements with different institutions around the state and some in Maine as well. All right, seeing it's about 7:15, if there is any last question, I will take it. Otherwise, we are going to call it night. And again, if you have any more specific questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to us. Email myself, email the school counselors, email anyone who the question may be appropriate to. And if I don't have the answer or they don't have the answer, we'll get it to the person who does have the appropriate answer. So thank you guys so much for being here and being with us. We really appreciate you taking some time tonight and bearing with us as we got through our technology hiccup, and hope the information was useful for you guys. And again, like I said, don't hesitate to reach out to us. We know this is a tough time. As we get closer to the end of the year, we'll look at the conditions and see what we can do for eighth grade, for you guys getting you here over the summer and doing an actual proper orientation. At a minimum, we will, like I said, have tours available for people. We did that last year, small group tours. So we're hoping to do more than that. I do see a club question about clubs starting again. Clubs start usually right in September, but people can join clubs throughout the year in a lot of cases. So thank you so much, everybody, and have a great, great night.